right. Now, we were showing Aleister Crowley, Albert Pike, and Eliphas Levi, all Satanists, who practicing magic. And what the Most High say? He say that we cannot be practicing and magic and calling after spirits and all that. But that's what these people do, right? And they call themselves today the Illuminati, right? But they just a bunch of Satanists running around. But we're going to go to the Torah now. We're going to go to the Torah and kill what these people is doing. What are all the things that they're into? Check this out, man. We're gonna go on the tour and bring this out. It's true. A puppet. George Bush a puppet, just like Obama a puppet. Right?
Cardinal Giorgio Bergoglio to the position of Pope Francis I was an unprecedented event the world has never before witnessed. It is the first time in history that a member of the Jesuit order has been elected to the highest position of the Roman Catholic Church.
The Jesuit order, the Society of Jesus.
Varied from
right?
Jubilation to matter-of-fact acceptance to disinterest. These very reactions reveal appalling ignorance of the true nature of the Jesuit order. Widely regarded as a benevolent missionary order, known for its educational institutions, the Jesuit order, as the Society of Jesus is commonly known, has long played an incredibly influential, albeit secretive, role in the destinies of nations, organizations, and individuals. Rulers, presidents, scholars, and even Catholics themselves, who are aware of the evil perpetrated by this powerful, far-reaching order, have left on record grave warnings that all should heed. Following is a compilation of quotes from a variety of sources. Some admit that their own diabolical organizations were modeled on Jesuit principles. Others give warning. A number of those who sought to warn did so at the cost of their lives. Proverbs 1:5 tells us, "A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsels." Ignatius Loyola, 1491-1556, founder of the Society of Jesus and its first superior general. "Nor will it contribute a little to our advantage if with caution and secrecy we foment and heighten the animosities that arise among princes and great men, even to such a degree that they may weaken each other. But if there appear any likelihood of reconciliation, then as soon as possible let us endeavor to be the mediators, lest others prevent us. Finally, let all with such artfulness gain the ascendant over princes, noblemen, and the magistrates of every place, that they may be ready at our beck even to sacrifice their nearest relations and most intimate friends when we say it is for our interest and advantage. Let proper methods be used to get knowledge of the animosities that arise among great men.
Hold on. Here we go.
The Dutch Revolution, 1568 to 1648. The 30 Years' War, 1618 to 1648. The Puritan Revolution, 1644 to 1653. The 7 Years, French Indian War, 1754 to 1763. While oppressing and weakening the peoples of the nations and the Semitic Hebrew Jewish race with the Holy Office of the Inquisition, aided by the Knights of Malta and later Scottish Rite Freemasonry from 1540 to 1773. We as God's people in 14th Amendment America have received the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior according to his blessed gospel set forth in his infallible Holy Scriptures, the authorized King James Version of 1611, must repent of our personal and national sins. Then we must forsake them. Some of those sins are: 1. Permitting the army of the Black Pope, the Company of the Society of Jesus, to exist, mightily prosper, and absolutely control the government of the United States through its Council on Foreign Relations within our borders. 2. Believing the Jesuit-controlled American press, which has continually lied and deceived us throughout the 20th century. 3. Permitting the Jesuits' Federal Reserve banking system and...
All right, Israel, we're going to get into these scriptures. We're in Leviticus chapter 19, verse 26. Check this out. You shall not eat over the blood. You say, you shall not eat over the blood. You shall not indulge in sorcery. You shall not indulge in sorcery. You shall not believe in lucky times. Right? You shall not round off the edge of your scalp. And you shall not destroy the edge of your beard. You shall not make a cut in your flesh for the dead. And the tattoo, and a tattoo shall not place, shall you not place upon yourselves. I am Yahweh, Hashem, right? Now, let's check this out. You know what I'm saying? Let's go down to verse 30. He say, my Sabbath you shall observe, and my sanctuary you shall revere. I am Yahweh. Do not turn to sorcery of the of those. And yet Anam, do not seek to be contaminated through them. I am Hashem. I am Yahweh. Right? So we must not turn to magic. You know what I'm saying? And observe in this wickedness of the sorceries. You know what I'm saying? Of this world. We got to stick with Yahweh. All right? I just wanted to put out some videos to show this truth in this world, because you know what I'm saying? Like the three world wars, you know what I'm saying? Albert Pike predicting them, you know? Well, Shalom Israel, I'm Russell Sullivan, Hebrew Israelite.